In part 5 of our lesson on graphs of sine and cosine, we're going to study how changes in period affect the graphs. In this example, we're given one period of the graph of y equals f of x, and we're being asked to sketch y equals f of 2x. From your college algebra class, you may remember that the point xy on the graph of f of x will turn into the point x over 2 comma y on the graph of f of 2x. Remember that you divide by whatever the coefficient of the argument is. So when we look at f of x compared to f of 2x, we know that the point 0, 1 on the graph of f of x is going to become 0 divided by 2, which of course is 0, 1 on the graph of f of 2x. The next point is 2 comma 3, so we have to take the 2 and divide it by 2, so it's going to become 1, 3. Next is 4 comma 3. 4 divided by 2 is 2, so this becomes the point 2, 3. And last we have 5 comma negative 2, and that's going to become 5 halves negative 2. So we know 5 halves is 2.5. All the attributes of the graph have to stay the same. We know connecting the first two points has to be a curve. Connecting the second point to the third point is a segment, and from the third point to the fourth point is also a segment. So here's our graph of f of 2x. So notice that the amplitude did not change. The y values stayed exactly what they were. The biggest y value is 3, the smallest y value is negative 2, just like on the original graph. What did change was the x values, so this is what we call a horizontal compression because the x values shrunk. Next, we have to graph y equals f of 1/2 x. So why don't you pause the video and try this one on your own? Then restart the video when you're ready to check your answers. If we have a point xy on the graph of f, we want to know what that point will become on the graph of f of 1/2 x. So remember that what happens is each x value is going to be divided by the coefficient. So the x value is going to be divided by 1/2. The y value remains unchanged. So that means what we really have here is 2x comma y. So if we compare the points on f of x with the points on f of 1/2 x, we see that 0, 1 is again going to remain at 0, 1 because multiplying 0 by 2 keeps it at 0. The next point is 2, 3. And we have to take that x value, divide it by a half, which we know is multiplying by 2. So that becomes 4, 3. The next value is 4, 3. And when we multiply 4 times 2, we're going to get 8. The y value stays 3. And finally, we have 5, negative 2 is going to become 10, negative 2. So as before, the first two points are connected by a curve. The next two points connected by a segment, and the last two another segment. So here's our graph of f of 1/2 x. So you can see that we actually had a horizontal expansion or a horizontal stretch. And once again, we can see that the amplitude remains unaffected, because f of 1/2 x will only affect the x values as I go from f of x to the new graph on f of 1/2 x. The amplitude stays the same, but it was a horizontal stretch. So next, we're going to sketch the graphs of y equals cosine of x and y equals cosine of 2x over the interval 0 to 2 pi. We're going to put both of them on this same coordinate plane. So pause the video, fill in this table of values that will happen, make the graphs, and then restart the video when you're ready to check your answers against mine. We know that cosine of x has 5 key values. The graph starts out at a maximum of 0, 1. Then it goes to a root at pi over 2, 0. It hits a minimum at pi negative 1, another root at 3 pi over 2, 0, and it ends the one cycle at a maximum of 2 pi 1. So we're ready to connect those key points with smooth curves, always smooth curves. So here's our graph of y equals cosine of x. And now we're ready to go ahead and work on our graph of cosine of 2x. We know that every point xy on the graph of cosine of x is going to turn into x over 2 comma y on the graph of cosine 2x. So 0, 1, since the x value is 0, dividing by 2 keeps it at 0, and it stays at 0, 1. Pi over 2 has to be divided by 2. Probably easier for you to think of it as multiplying by 1/2. And you can see that dividing pi over 2 by 2, in other words, multiplying by a half, is going to give us pi over 4 comma 0. The y value remains unchanged. Now on our graph, pi over 2 is here, which means pi over 4 would be right here. The next point, pi comma negative 1, divide the x value by 2, and we get pi over 2, negative 1. 3 pi over 2 divided by 2. Again, I would suggest you think of it as multiplying times 1/2. It makes it easier to see that it's going to be 3 pi over 4, comma 0. So now when you look at the dotted lines on the graph, you can see that we're going by pi over 4. So that's 1 pi over 4, 2 pi over 4. So that means this would be 3 pi over 4. And we're plotting the point 3 pi over 4, 0. And the fifth key point, 2 pi divided by 2, is going to be pi, comma 1. And now we're ready to connect those key values with smooth curves. This is our graph of y equals cosine of 2x. And you can see that we had a horizontal compression. If you think of the original graph made out of a wire, for example, or like a slinky, it's like we took the slinky and compressed it horizontally this way so that it gets done in half the time. And we can see that the period of y equals cosine of 2x is pi. The whole entire graph is finished with the one cycle at pi. So the period is equal to pi. And that makes sense, because if we think of the normal period is 2 pi, and every x value on the graph has to get divided by 2 because the coefficient of the argument is a 2. If we take the period of cosine of x and we know we have a horizontal compression by a factor of 2, it makes sense that we would take 2 pi, divide it by 2, and that gets us to pi. And that's exactly what's happening. So whatever the coefficient of the argument is in the cosine or sine function, we take 2 pi and divide it by that coefficient. So for changes in period, for y equals sine of bx or y equals cosine of bx, we see that the new period is going to become 2 pi divided by b, where b is the coefficient of the argument. And for the points on the graph, each x value on the graph is divided by b.